The Flemings are in the house! Yes!
Oh, my God.
Well, looks like he works out quite a bit.
Steffi, get him up here!
Please, please, please.
10 or 15 years ago, it felt like the grown-ups ruled the world, and now it feels like the kids rule the world. And maybe, you know, I feel like I'm somewhere in between. I feel like, I still feel like a kid and I make movies and comedies, but I've been doing it for a while and I kind of found myself in the middle. You know, there's people making movies who are 23, 24, 25 like I was when I started, and then people making them in their 60s and 70s. And, you know, I just sort of, my own personal experience and having a daughter and thinking about what world she's going to grow up in, that kind of, all that stuff just felt like interesting fodder for a movie.
Have a little surprise.
Ta-da!
Is that our Christmas card?
It's all you!
It says happy holidays and everything.
It says happy holidays?
Yeah.
Oh, I gave the guy the Christmas card. I didn't know he put happy holidays on there. I guess that's on me forever now.
He manages to get away with stuff that I thought he would never be able to get away with. You know, because he's James Franco and he's got this smile and this glint in his eye and this playfulness. And so he can say some of the most offensive things to this nice Midwestern family, but he's not doing it to get a rise out of them. He's just, it's the idea is that no one taught this guy how to act.
Turns out her boyfriend is this internet zillionaire.
Laird has literally no filter, but he's a really good guy.
Remember that night in the hot tub?
Steph opened up like a flower. You should have seen it.
I shouldn't have seen it, but now I feel like I have.
I'm sure after all those seasons of Breaking Bad, playing such an intense character, that he goes through a lot of pain on this movie, but it's all, you know, for the sake of laughs. So I think he's enjoying that, and he's definitely jumped headfirst into our comedic waters.
I don't like bodyguards around, so I just had Gustav train me.
He's as strange as they come.
Your reaction time is getting quicker.
But what happened to the evasive parkour?
Keegan has this rare ability to be extraordinarily funny and grounded. And so the character could be off the rails, and but I think every moment is sort of rooted in this emotional truth where he really does care about this guy and he cares about the Flemings and he wants everyone to be happy. But he's also just such an inventive comedian that, you know, he comes up with ridiculous things and again manages to root them in reality.
No father would want their daughter with this guy.
My instinct is to hug you right now.
Good night.
I don't know what his issues are. Oh my, oh my. I feel like I'm so normal.
During the takes, you know, I'm watching the monitors closely, just trying to watch the movie unfold. And my brain is going quickly and I'm shouting ideas out or thinking about, well, what if we did this or what about that? So it's very, you know, it does make me have to be on my toes. You know, because I'm not just watching, sitting back, letting the actors do their thing. It's a very interactive process.
On Christmas Day, I'm gonna ask Steffi to marry me, and I'd really like your blessing. Yeah.
No.
Just give me a couple days to win you over. By Christmas morning, you're gonna be calling me son. I'm gonna be calling you dad.
Don't think that's gonna happen.
I think it's gonna, Dad.
I know it won't.
Dad, it will.
Stop that.
What, Dad?
That, stop that.
Dad, what are you talking about?
You know, I think the movie is about the fact that there's value in every way of doing things. The tech world, there's nothing wrong with high tech and with creating apps and playing games and stuff like that, and just, you know, programming and coding. That's cool. But also, Ned, you know, Cranston's character's way of life, there's something very decent and important about that too, where you make personal connections and you shake someone's hand and you have a certain value system and you take your time with things. I think that's, you know, that's super important as well.
You could be dating anyone. Why Laird?
He makes me really happy.
He is wrapping his tentacles around every member of this family.
Because of his influence?
Your mother has lost her mind.
Look at this! It's called twerping.
Throughout the day, you just discover certain veins of comedy that you didn't know were going to be there in the morning. And that's, to me, it's a free-for-all. It's a very collaborative, open process where the actors yell things out. I'll yell out ideas during the take. They'll jump on it. They'll pitch ideas back to me. Obviously, it's my job at the end of the day to cull through everything and figure out what fits the tone. Or sometimes they might go down a road that is funny but not quite in the right tone, and I'll try to bring them back to the right tone, or vice versa. But it just makes it fun and very alive. And you know, it's one of my favorite things to be on set and you just find something that didn't exist in the morning, and by 2 o'clock, it's almost become a running joke on set. and then you put it in other scenes. And it just makes it, I think, fresh and funny and alive.
I am gonna take this octopus down.
Been public enemy since you got PE with boom! Shaka-laka-laka!
Just hope that people kind of get on board with the characters emotionally, and that allows them to feel the pain and suffering that Ned goes through, and to kind of see it from Ned's side and Laird's side and Stephanie's side, and just get in there with this family and this new boyfriend and you know, go on this roller coaster with them.